Rapa Nui, Chile, better known as Easter Island.
This is the location of one of the most enduring ancient mysteries known to humankind.
The iconic stone heads on this island, known as Moai, are incredible feats of engineering.
For centuries, archaeologists have struggled to fully understand them. One of the most enduring mysteries is why the location for each of the nearly 1,000 statues was chosen.
These massive statues are scattered all over the island without any apparent patterning.
If their purpose was purely symbolic or ritualistic, we would expect them to be placed up in really highly visible places like hilltops where everybody can see them. But they're not. The placement of the Moai doesn't seem to make any sense.
So what were the islanders thinking?
Now, digital technology reveals the answer with brand new analysis that unlocks the hidden logic to the statues' locations.
The Moai were the guardians of what these people needed most.
Without this, the Rapa Nui knew their communities would be doomed.
Rapa Nui is one of the most remote inhabited islands in the world.
When you first land there, you notice that the landscape is rather bleak. There's not a lot of trees, there's limited rainfall, the soil quality is poor, so growing food is tough, and finding fresh water is a nightmare.
Between the 13th and 18th centuries CE, the islanders carved hundreds of moai, some reaching 30 feet in height and weighing over 80 tons. Researchers have been studying the statues for centuries, trying to understand why they were built.
I have been to Easter Island to study these ancient statues, and the perceived wisdom is that these carved stones represent powerful ancestors.
The statues face inland, watching over the island's inhabitants. For centuries, the Moai have been associated with religious rituals on the island.
Many of the statues were located within a few hundred meters of villages, and they were known to be important religious and ritual centers where the community would come together at certain times of the year.
The Moai functioned as conduits for communication with the gods.
The rituals help archaeologists understand what the megaliths represent. But questions remain about how the statue positions were chosen. Hauling the megaliths across the unforgiving terrain would have drained huge amounts of energy. This leads archaeologists to speculate that these locations must have offered some strategic benefit.
Were the Moai sited in such a way to be close to resources the islanders needed to survive?
To uncover what could be so valuable, researchers head to the place with the highest concentration of Moai.
There are almost 900 statues on the island, and most of them were carved in a quarry called Ranu Raraku. And here, several hundred statues are still left in place.
This is the Easter Island statue headquarters, if you will. If there is some vital resource that drove the placement of these statues on the island, then it's going to be here, in this quarry.
Archaeologists examine the site for clues. At first glance, they have little to go on.
There doesn't seem to be much here besides grass and volcanic rock, so what are we not seeing?
Could the evidence they need be hidden beneath the surface? They excavate the area around the statues and send soil samples for laboratory analysis. The results are intriguing.
As it happens, the quarry soil samples contain the remains of sweet potatoes.
Sweet potatoes were one of the primary sources of food on Easter Island before Europeans arrived. They were incredibly important for the inhabitants' survival.
Further analysis suggests sweet potato wasn't the only crop being cultivated at the quarry.
Banana, taro, and paper mulberry were all being grown here too.
As the researchers dig deeper, chemical analysis of the soil reveals why.
there are extraordinarily high levels of nutrients like calcium and phosphate in the quarry soil. These elements are key to helping plants grow and to ensure high yields.
The soil was not always this nutritious. Over time, the quarrying activity in this area enriched it.
Unlike other parts of the island where the nutrients are being leached away, the influx of rock from the quarry and process would have replenished them. It was like a natural fertilizer.
This brand new insight may explain why so many megaliths were erected in this quarry.
They were probably deliberately placed in the quarry to help support the success of the crops.
Chances are the islanders put two and two together and made a correlation between the presence of the statues and the crops that were doing really well.
The success of these crops must have seemed like a gift from the gods.
Archaeologists conclude the moai were erected at the quarry to mark a reliable food supply. They now ask whether the availability of natural resources could also explain the locations of the other Easter Island heads.
Food is undoubtedly vital, but it's not the most important resource for human survival.
We can survive for weeks without food, but only days without water.
On Rapa Nui, fresh water is hard to come by.
There are some freshwater lakes and volcanic craters, but there are few other freshwater sources on the island and no permanent streams.
The scarcity of freshwater is down to the island's complex geology.
The rocks on Rapa Nui are incredibly porous. Fresh water passes through the ground into aquifers below, seeping into caves and emerging around the coast.
The shortage of freshwater means a reliable source would have been highly prized. Perhaps the moai marked these sites. To test their theory, researchers first mapped the location of the base of the statues, known as the ahu.
The ahu is the platform upon which the moai stand. A single ahu platform can support multiple moai.
Next, they compare them to the locations of three different types of resources: crops, fish, and freshwater. Could any of these be the secret to explain the locations of the Easter Island heads? In the tech lab, a new digital mapping technique could at last reveal the answer.
This evidence makes complete sense. Statistical analysis is a uniquely useful archaeological tool for solving ancient mysteries. We're focusing on the eastern end of the island because that's where we have the most complete data. Now, let's plot the ahu, and let's represent them using the Easter Island heads. And next, the fresh water sources in blue. By eye, it's a pretty good correlation. We've got a concentration along most of both coasts. To make a more conclusive link, I can apply statistical analysis here to visualize the proximity of the ahu to fresh water sources. The blue areas are close to fresh water sources, while the yellow farther away. And what's really fascinating is that most of the ahu heads are in the blue areas near water sources. It really does seem like there's a genuine relationship. What's more, an analytical process known as spatially explicit point process modeling reinforces this.
The spatial modeling compares the proximity of different resources to the ahu and uses statistical analysis to determine which resource offers the strongest link.
It rules out that this ahu freshwater relationship is by chance, and it demonstrates their strong association with freshwater as opposed to other resources.
The statues could also be used to demarcate particular territory. And what this new study suggests is they may also be used to show ownership of certain freshwater resources.
These giant statues serve to safeguard the water sources on this dry island. And that's because without it, the islanders knew they would be doomed.